previously.
I don't really have a reason to even use this PC anymore, though I may want to install a lightweight Linux distro.
Let's finally do that and see what else I can do on this really old PC from 2007 in the current year. In this video, we're going to find out just what you can do with the PC that's almost two decades old. Now, the obvious first thing you can do is install old versions of Windows the PC was made for. This one was made for Windows Vista. I actually reinstalled Vista on this for the sole purpose of playing Star Wars Battlefront 2. Now that I have the game working on my main PC, note the DVD version, not the Steam and GOG version, this PC is essentially worthless. Or is it? Because there's a thing called Linux, and that can run on really old hardware, making my PC able to actually use the internet and not total e-waste. I'm installing Debian because it's very lightweight by default, especially compared to Mint. This is how well Mint ran on the live disk environment.
I don't think Linux Mint is the right system for this. Just running nothing but the system monitor, it's running like this. That's pretty bad.
I didn't even try after seeing how bad it worked. This PC was struggling.
Got this SSD that used to have Windows on it that has been completely shredded of any remnants of such. And now it's gonna have Linux on it.
Alright. Quick stop. Don't use no-name flash drives. They're the devil. The installation would corrupt until I used a name-brand flash drive. Now that I got Debian all set up, let's install NeoFetch and see what my specs are. Not great, but I installed Steam anyway, and guess what? It actually works. The games...
Now it's time for everybody's favorite subject. Math! Answer the three questions correctly.
Not so much. I even tried remotely streaming them from my main PC, and that was an experience.
Okay, so I'm technically playing Skyrim on this. Hello? It didn't work.
Star Wars Battlefront 2 took like 10 minutes to load, running off of wine. I merely entertained the idea of playing the training mission, and it immediately crashed. A far cry from Windows Vista's ability on this PC. The biggest reason my PC isn't able to play games well is GPU drivers. I tried getting the Nvidia driver to work, but I broke the entire system in the process, so I had to reinstall and use the Nuvo driver. Because they're so old and essentially a security vulnerability, they aren't even supported on this version of Debian, and are only supported on a release that's near end of life. And using an OS with no security support exclusively for mediocre at best gaming on a really old PC when you have a much better one, is asinine. This Nvidia driver supposedly works on Arch through the AUR, but is it really worth installing Arch just for mediocre gaming? YouTube only sort of works, depending on the resolution picked for the video. I'm sure there's better, less bloated web browsers though, but that won't help bloated sites like YouTube very much. You can also use your old PC as a server to stream movies with Plex or Jellyfin, watching movies you own from anywhere. Never mind, my CPU is so old that it can't even handle streaming to other devices in the house. If we compare specs, my phone would be more able to stream Plex than this PC.
But not really, because Plex doesn't officially support having Android as a Plex media server.
Oh well, I'll just use my normal PC. No big deal. But the best thing you can do with your old PC is install Debian and use this as your wallpaper, because it's funny. But yeah, you can web browse. You can do Word document editing. Put stickers on it, I don't know. So, apparently you can't really do much with the PC with these specs today. I mean, you can, but you shouldn't if you have a better computer or any smartphone made this decade. I don't know. I don't have anything else to say. Bye!